Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. Matthew 8:20 says, foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man had nowhere to lay his head. It points towards the reversal of values found in the figure of Jesus Christ and his message. From the moment of his birth, he belongs outside the realm of what is considered important and powerful in worldly terms. Christmas is a special time of the year for all of us. It's more than a day just to get and give away presents. Instead, it is a time for us to reflect on loving others just like Jesus did and for prioritizing the true things that actually matter in our heart. Jesus, through his birth in the manger, gives us an important message. Let's hear the word of God and reflect.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I welcome each one of you to this small sharing session. First of all, I wish all of you a Merry Christmas. Today we celebrate the birthday of Jesus. We all celebrate our birthdays, but here, 2020th birthday of Jesus. That's the difference. When we celebrate our own birthdays and others, you all come together, you share our joy, our peace, our happiness, and we speak a lot of about the person. We love the person, we give gift, and we share our joy. That way we celebrate our own birthdays and our dear ones. Here also we celebrate the birthday of Jesus. In one of the Christmas Eve, I was in one of the foreign countries. Then I noticed people are coming together and they have lot of celebrations. Then I asked one of my friends, oh, these people are celebrating Christmas very much. And then they said, no sister, they don't know what they are doing. Maybe they are thinking that they are celebrating the birthday of Santa Claus. It's not the birthday of Santa Claus, the birthday of Jesus Christ. Who is Jesus Christ? Who is the Son of God? He has come down this world not to give us love, joy, peace in abundance. That is Christmas. So, when we think about Christmas, what must come to our life, come to our mind? Lot of things we can meditate upon this day. First of all, we can see the manifestation of God's love. Let us go to Bethlehem in Judea, where Jesus was born. We can see no preparation, nothing was there. Only we see a manger there. There Jesus was born. But when we come to Genesis, first letter of Genesis, we can see how the Lord prepared the world to create man. Now, to create man, he prepared a royal place. He did everything in perfect, lot of orders. Everything he has done there before creating man. But to send his only son Jesus, nothing was there. There we can see how much he loved us. We cannot share his love. We cannot meditate the depth of his love. That we can see when we celebrate this Christmas. Let us see in Psalm chapter 8 verse 3 to 9. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established. What are human beings that you are mindful of them? Mortals that you care for them. Yet you have made them a little lower than God and crowned them with glory and honor. You have given them dominion over the works of their hands. Your hands, you have put all things under their feet, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. He prepared, he gave everything to man before creating him. But to send his Son, what he has done, that shows he loved us so much. He loved us so much. So when we go to the manger, lot of things we can meditate from there. First of all, the manger tells us, or the baby Jesus tells us, we have to look down always. We have to look down, and then we can live peacefully in this world. Secondly, we can see Jesus tells us, unite or build up our relationship. While celebrating this Christmas, see our relationships. Anybody can go to Bethlehem. Anybody can see this baby Jesus united mankind together. Through the sin, man went away from God, men separated each other. But by the birth of Jesus, he once again united mankind together. He prepared the way for the man to come together. While celebrating Christmas, let us see our relationship. Who all are standing very far, bring them back to our life. Christmas tells us. And also, we can see from the manger that all are equal in this world. There is no difference, rich or poor, educated or uneducated, illiterate, or according to caste or creed. There is no separation in this world. All are equal in this world. While celebrating 2020th birthday of Jesus, let us examine ourselves. Do we have an open heart? Do we love everyone? Do you show partiality to anyone else? That we have to stop during this Christmas. Again, Christmas tells us, from the manger we can read that the meaning of our life, where we are coming from, where we are going. Christmas tells us the value of our life. We are all respected by God. We have given life by God. It's not our creation. We should love, we should honor, we should respect our own life. We cannot give up our life. We cannot put down our life. It's coming from God. We are going back to God. Again, when we think about this Christmas, Christmas tells us that we should respect life, means we don't do abortion. We cannot kill the child. Whatever may be the situation, God is there. Think about Mother Mary. There was no way to give the birth. But Mother Mary, what she did there. So in this Christmas, let us respect the life. Stop abortion. Don't kill any child. When men and women come together, there is God in between, and God gave life that we have no right to finish, to kill, or expect life. Christmas tells us. Again, we can see, we can read from the manger, from this birthday, that God is controlling this world. In the paradise, the first chapter of Genesis, we can see lot of orders. Everything was in order, the climate, the animals, everything was in order. Completely, perfectly it was in order. But after the sin, when man committed sin, lot of disorders, discomfort, disease, everything come to this world. But from the manger, from the when we celebrate this Christmas, we can see that when we call out His name, all the tensions and worries, everything will stop. We can live a peaceful life because we celebrate the birthday of Jesus, one who saved the world, one who has come down to save the world. When you call out His name, this Christmas tells us, don't live a tense life. Don't be worried about anything else. The Savior is close to us. If you are a sick person, call out His name. If you see that everything is in disorder, you call out Jesus, the Savior. He is ready to come closer to us and put it everything in order. So Christmas tells us lot of things. It's not a simple celebration. This Christmas tells us to keep our life again in order. It's good to share gifts and greetings, everything. But this year it's not possible because of COVID. But we can put our own life in order. This Christmas tells us you put your own life in order. In other celebrations, we were worried, we are thinking about others, bringing people together, calling them, sending cards, greetings, everything. But the 2020th Christmas birthday tells us you put your own life in order. So Jesus is coming closer to you. Call out His name. Call Jesus. Accept Jesus as our own Savior. Accept Jesus as our own Master. Accept Jesus as our own way, our own life, our own truth. So while celebrating this Christmas, let us try to change our life. Take the right decision. I follow Jesus. I follow His paths. All the promises, all the prophecies, everything fulfilled in this birthday. So, whatever the Lord promised us, wanted to fulfill in our life, for that we should open our life before the Lord. Once again, I wish you a Merry Christmas. Let this Christmas give us lot of joy, peace, patience. Amen. Happy birthday to you.